Hello, welcome to my channel. I'm Nessie. Monks and Mystics has literally just been released. I've just downloaded it. So, I'm going to do a quick video looking at some of the new features before I kind of, I go back and to the main Norse game that we're doing. Let's pick somewhere. Grima Nidors. Let's have a look at him, actually. I'm not going to bother creating a new character for this because it's. We're just going to delve in, have a look. Sorry, I'm just going over all of this, seeing if there's anything new being added. Doesn't look like it. Looks like it's oh, here we are. Yeah, so we've got devil worshippers and Turk. Conquerors. We'll just leave that because I haven't had a proper look at those yet. This is literally my first time going through the game. So, got this new tab here. Sorry, I'm using the mouse with the wrong hand. So, societies. I think this is the only one we can join as a Norse. Why can I not look to join it though? I don't know. So we've got a treasury tab here as well, so like when we get artifacts, that'll come in. Pick that. They've also, from just looking at the live stream, updated the kind of find characters thing. So we've got diplomatic range here, so we want them to be within diplomatic range. Will they join our court? Yes, search hall. Women. So there's no one that currently fits that. There we go. Yeah, don't care about that. Why can I not join this society? Must be a sinner. Okay. Well, we'll just have a go and see how we get on. Declare war on you, subjugation to expand. This is where we find out he's got more troops than us. Nope. Yeah, another thing that's been introduced is the fact that when you have allies joining you in a war, you can direct them So that'll be interesting to see. Yeah, getting gold. If you've been watching the live stream, then you know that this is just one of many societies. I think this might be the only one for the North, I'm not sure. There is one. There's a few for Christianity. There's Lucifer's Own, which is a satanic society. So that'll be quite interesting, you know, if you want to have a playthrough on that. I don't think anything here is being changed. Oh, we can mark decisions as important. Okay. Yep, they've also changed. Let me just get rid of this. They've also changed the prisoner tab, made it more effective to kind of sort people. And, you know, I'm guessing here it will be like, oh, well, you can filter between will it give you extra tyranny, will it not? So that'll be kind of interesting to look at as the game goes on. Slowly working our way through here. I was really hoping to be able to join the society straight away, but need to be a sinner. Maybe if I console it? Yep, there we go. Can now show interest. And that's also increased our marshal a little bit. Just to, you know, note, I am only doing the console so I can kind of explore the society and show you guys a little bit of it. Because I've not done any of this yet, and I'm interested to see. There's no way of like looking at all the societies, I don't think. Maybe the series I do with Monks and Mystics when I get around to doing that will be, you know, playing as a Catholic, exploring some of the societies that are available for Catholicism. Quite like the idea of taking Ireland and making Ireland a major power. How many troops can you raise? 568. So we'll leave you be for now. I'm having dinner party. Oh, sorry. I am having dinner and plenty of drinks with good eye Scully of Nidoros tonight. It's lovely, yet what I'm most charmed by is Scully himself. Why else should I would I not immediately stop our conversation, which has slowly begun to touch upon almost some heretical ideas, questioning the salvation of Odin. If we do not ask questions, why did Odin make us curious? Walking the palisades of my village, I'm joined by Godai Scully. I find myself agreeing with a lot of the concepts he presents. and the futility of prayer particularly resonates with me. Suddenly he turns to me and presses a small leather pouch into my hand. My lord, will you carry this with you for protection? I'll keep it hidden and I thank you. So these are the kind of chain of events that lead to you kind of gaining entry to the society. What if I told you that all you've been taught to believe in is a lie? Squilly continues, throwing a cautious glance around us before pulling up his sleeve, revealing a scar in the shape of Hell's mark. Odin's a liar. Reject the tyrant deity and let Hell guide your steps. You truly are a seed maiden, then. I don't know how to pronounce that. Can you bring down my enemies? We might if you offer yourself up to Hell. He will grant you powers Odin has kept from us humans. Fingering the leather pouch in my pocket, I slowly nod. Oh, and I think you'll enjoy it, he said with a knowing smile. If there's any chance it will bring down my enemies, I will. Okay, on with conquering. 663 men. Ooh. It's been some time since Gordy Squirrel was in contact with me. I've been pondering about what Odin would think of me for venturing down this path, but Squirrel has already offered me more support than Odin ever has. I've begun studying books on the occult and so far I'm finding the views preached at the temple to be narrow-minded at best. The lies are meant to hold us back. How many troops can you raise? 440. What about you? Found some cryptic scrawlings written in blood on my bedroom door this morning. Guards say they haven't seen anyone enter during the night, and I dare not ask my seeress to decipher it. Yet I think I understand it. The mark of Hell. Of course, the bargain must be struck. This child. It's interesting. Instead of drilling the commanders, Marshal Toki has been fighting them. There's truly a lack of discipline in your ranks, so great. Brother Grimir, we've received word of your dedication and desire to join the Legion of the True Lord. I thought that was a Time Lord then. Await the messenger, let the Dark One guide you. Finally. I've met an intriguing and hypnotically beautiful woman at court. Apparently this Homefried is a foreign diplomat. Engaged in conversation for the first time today and we spoke at length about passages from the sagas. I was shocked when she carefully pulled up her sleeve revealing the mark of Hell. You're the messenger? She smiles and pleased to find you not only a charming man, Grimmer, but one also capable of intellectual discourse. The brethren value the pursuit of knowledge, you see, in addition to more earthly pursuits. Her smile turns into a predatory grin as she continues. We'll soon see exactly how committed you are. What do you need me to do? Homefried escorts me to my bedchamber. I hesitate upon entering, finding it flooded with light, as candles form a circle around my bed. Several hooded figures surround the room, chanting in unison. Fear not, brother. Power and pleasure, these are the gifts of Hell. Ooh, Zexidens. I like the sound of that. When I wake up, the cloaked figures are gone, and Homefried is lying next to me, a smile tugging at the corner of her mouth. Welcome to the Fellowship of Hell, Grimmer, she says. I hold her close, wondering how I look back at this moment. I wish you had found me sooner. And see... Our clothing has changed to represent the fact we are now in the secret society. Trollmarder. So, can we leave society? No, we're not going to leave society. Let's try and recruit someone. No, you're already members. Apparently you are too. Let's try and recruit you. Raise our troops. And off we go. Meeting with Ormir, I made sure only to cautiously question the absolute power of this almighty Odin. Thankfully, it seems that my carefully chosen ways had the desired effect on him. From his glittering eyes, I get the distinct impression that he enjoyed the philosophical aspect of our conversation. A sensible man. I've arranged a run-in with Ormir on the palisades of his village today. His face lights up upon seeing me and we set about talking for hours. I offer him a protection spell. And a leather pouch, of course. I do not explain the content yet, he smiles, accepting the token. He just needs one little push. When I proceed to reveal the brand of my lower arm, certain that the final hook would sink in, he inhales sharply, worrying me for a second. Then he says, "You truly are a saved Marlene," eager and relieved. "Can you help me bring down my enemies?" he continues, eyes pleading. "Patience, brother. We'll speak more soon." Can I raise any? No. Probably. Promote commander, but I can't. I have not enough prestige. In the case of battle, your men have managed to corner striker. He resisted bravely before they slew him. Good riddance. So here's another interesting thing. A daughter was born to Grimmer of Nidoros and Chiefess Adelheid of Nidoros, named Asa. Now we can click these things here, so name her after her mother, that gives her a mother's name. No valid grandmother, no random ancestor, or we can just randomize names. So we'll call it Toyra. That makes it easier for when you want to name people. And I have 200 power. Let's try and recruit someone else. No, oh, he's not interested in joining. That is a shame. Let's see, can we recruit him? I want more dark power. More power, give me more. Meeting with Stain, I made sure to only cautiously question the absolute power of his almighty own. Oh well. Do we have any people in court we could recruit? Try and take his territory, but I don't think we've got enough people for that. No. Helsingad, we could try and take. Oh, we've got a mission. Hell's favors. Spademar. Grima, an opportunity to strike at the foolish followers of false gods has presented itself. The Godais and Nidoras are ignorant to the true state of the world. Tear down their idols and steal their wealth in the name of Hell. Accept. Oh, there we go. My preparation plans to be made. A servant has been bribed to leave a side door to the temple in Nidoros open so that eyes and some faithful servants can enter and do the dark bidding of hell. It's time. Rikisa looks dazed as she is dragged to the altar, but you can see dawning comprehension on her face as she is tied down. You ignore her begging as chants of praise to hell build to a crescendo. Finally, it is time. You swing your blade in an overhead arc, which ends in Rikisa's heart. Hail hell! And we gain dark power. Always good. As I and a group of my faithful make our way through the temple, I spot a Godai tending to their duties in the middle of the night. Kill them. Dead men tell no tales. Hmm. Navigating our way through the small temple, I and my companions have entered the small room that goes for the inner sanctum. The room contains the sparsest possible honorings to Odin and the scant few decorative idols and relics. The state of this place clearly shows the superiority of our cause. Do we want 5 gold? No, we want dark power. We'll burn it all. The night is silent as we exit the temple, our foul rites making sure that the wholeness of the place is tented for years to come. Though unfortunately our moral authority goes down. Though my last act of worship has been some time ago, I can still sense an human touch upon my soul whenever I think about what I did. I've become a changed man. All for the better. Our concubine is pregnant. Damn it. Ah. Meeting with Vagan, I made sure to only cautiously question the absolute power of his almighty Odin. Thankfully, it seems that my carefully chosen words had the desired effect upon him. From his glittering eyes, I got the distinct impression that he enjoyed the philosophical aspect of our conversation. Sensible man. I've arranged a run-in with Vagan on the palisades of his village today. His face lights up upon seeing me, and we stay out talking for hours. After him a protection spell and a leather pouch, of course, I do not explain the content, yet he smiles, accepting the token. Let's see if we can recruit to you. It's always handy to have more people following hell. Title. No, we have to do it this way. Having your crap, we don't want you, we want Stella. It's going to be a close one, but they're going to win. Well, maybe not. So what's our dark power like? Relatively good, 7%. 710. We're getting there. If you're careful, you can hear the chanting in the background. That's pretty cool. Helgi. He's pretty good, actually. Perfect. We shall of course try and recruit him when we're not at war. Name after father. He's Grimmer the Second. Has to be done, doesn't it? Anything we can do here? No. Factions, none. We'll have to try and recruit more people. The more people recruit, the more powerful we become. All for peace. We need to recruit more people. Ah, disappointing, but can we form a duchy? We need 164 gold. So let's store our gold. Is there anyone else we can try and recruit? Doesn't look like it, does it? Not out of our council anyway. Let's try and recruit a wife. Ah. There she goes. A wife shall now join. Trying to recruit more. It's a shame. Our wife's pregnant. Ooh. I need to expand our armies. Oh, it's a shame. What's our troop status like? For that to build up, and then we'll try and go after Hyde Mark. Need more cash. My wife, Adelheid, wants me to join her for a lark over in Hydemark. There's a turbulent god out there who's been antagonizing the Fellowship of Hell for quite some time. It's time to teach the arrogant fools a lesson in some manners. We found the zealous god in Hydemark praying in seclusion. Adelheid snuck up from behind and gave the fool a hard kick in the head. As I gave a devotion to Angaboda, Adelheid proceeded to relieve herself on the comatose breach, and then the butchery commenced. I'll do that. Come name Skuld. An opportunity to strike. Yeah. Sure. Let's create a temple again. Get 100 dark power. There we go. Hey, we gained a rank. Demonic possession. Wow, this is quite cool. So enables right clicking on your character's portrait to summon a familiar in exchange for dark power. Tainted Touch enables right clicking the portraits of your vassals, courtiers, and rivals and attempt to curse them with bad health and disease in exchange for dark power. Hmm. Yeah, I can afford to lose 50. Idiot. Improve the scheme. Yeah. Demonic possession him. Making him loyal to us. That is disappointing, but you're still loyal. So I shall forgive you. Are you still at war? As soon as he's like not at war, we'll try and recruit him because he'd be pretty interesting to have. My chancellor and brother in darkness, Scully, is feeling less vicious. Less vicious? And just suggested that we might stage an impromptu orgy together in the Great Serpent Course. What a lovely idea. I'll wear my horned helmet. I love it. My memories of the last few days of Dreamlight, there was lots of smoke and a cackling old crow and a nubile young woman with a long tail that could do all kinds of things. Oh, and there's a lot of midget ordering me in schoolie in various interesting positions. I never realized I liked men that way. Would please hell greatly to should Hrodgar fall into depravity. It's a shame. My agents have proved the worth. It appears that Hrodgar has taken a liking for the pleasures of flesh. A night of debauchery could well turn his secret liking into a public known love. I shall write the invitation. We've got a ship. Marshall, but never mind. Damn it. Who are you at war with now? Grodi, who are you? So can it be any godite or? Oh. Sorry, don't know why I was laughing at that. I just found it kind of funny that no person lives in a life entirely devoid of sim, neither does Gertie Boldi. Just have to find some traits of his character that I can build on. Damn it. This one's a difficult one. Sometime now, my dear wife and sister in darkness, Adelheid and I have been researching the proper ritual for invoking a certain Jotun lord. A few weeks back, our brethren managed to procure an ancient clay tablet with the missing incantation. Stand ready to attain powers undreamed of by mortal men. Unlimited power! A grand summoning. Our coven surrounds the summoning circle, the correct symbols drawn, the fatty candles burning a sickly green. Adelheid intones the final invocation just as I offer the sacrifice. Distracted by the spurting of blood, at first I didn't notice the man standing in the circle like he was there all along. Looking straight at me with a smirk, he says, "Brilliantly done, child. You have no understanding of the forces you are meddling with, but I did find your sacrifice pleasing. So, quid pro quo, name your desire." At first, Helgi resisted fiercely, but it slowly dawned on him that no god would bother to answer his prayers. Come morning, I was exhausted, but Helgi was more than willing to swear allegiance to his true master. The light no longer blinds you, dear brother. I would like to declare war, but I need money, so I'm not going to do it. He's not a sinner. Home gears. I like that name, Starkader. Aha, he's finally a sinner. Damn it. I need to try and correct. My brethren are not having much luck in their attempts to abduct Kettleman. Perhaps the Fellowship of Hell are not influential enough to pull it off. No, I'll just have to be patient. Ah, oh, we need more dark power, damn it. Prove the scheme. Well, my guest Kettleman has yet to understand the true nature of the world. Her methods of persuasion might get through to him. Not many survived the long journey to truth, since you can bear it once it is revealed to them, but Kettleman would be an asset to our ranks. Ah, good. Just need to corrupt a Godai. Damn it. All to hell. That wasn't meant to happen. Tainted touch. On the on. Good. Perhaps he will die soon. Because I do not want to be answering to him. Looks child focus. She's shite. Could be a diplomat. There's no way we can win this. This wasn't meant to happen. I was meant to be able to declare my duchy Hurry up and die, because then hopefully war won't be valid anymore. Fine, offer peace, surrender. Why won't you? I'm trying to surrender to you. But you won't accept it, because you're a dickhead. Excuse my French. You've won, so why won't you accept my surrender? Something is happening within the society, because that little tinkle means that something's going on. Why are troops suddenly up there? Bugger off, I'm not giving you any more money. You're already taking all my territory off me, bastard. I'll get my revenge. After the council meeting, Steward Gunmire asked me to exchange a few words in private. Apparently, he has uncovered a rumour concerning a rare artifact. I'm gonna believe there is some truth to the rumour and urged me to have. Good idea. Gotta be. Damn it. Why is this such a difficult? Right, guys, I'm gonna leave that here. We've had a look at it. There's nothing much more I can show you. I will eventually do a proper series with it. So. Yeah, so I will leave it there. All right, guys. Bye.